everything
and
up.
And he said, this is going to be boring.
Famous last words.
We started with this dog boss who had a tear in its ear that needed to be debrided or the old stuff taken off and then stitched up. So for boss, we wanted to use a sedative that was something that we could reverse very easily and would not be too long lasting, but would definitely immobilize him. And then in addition to that, we were going to use a local anesthetic just right on that so that he wouldn't move. We could stitch it up really quick and then we could reverse it and he would wake up and be ready to go home. Now this particular anesthetic does have the effect that it frequently makes their heart rate drop really, really low. As long as their blood pressure is okay, I actually don't get too worried about it. But during this, what I have happened here...
Oh, there you are. Finally kicked in. Back to my blood.
And that problem is that we have all these little waves before we have this big QRS. This is a P wave. P wave, P wave, QRS. The heart rate is pretty good, 93. I'm okay with that. Except if you look at this, this is not a normal strip at all. So to me, what I'm seeing here is I'm seeing all of these P waves and no Q waves. That's what we would call heart block. Again, something that can happen, but I don't like it. That's when I tell Jessie, reverse this dog and let's get this procedure done and get it taken care of.
All the way.
Put a little local in. Debride it. He may very well jump off the table at some point here, so.
Yeah.
This goes to there, that goes to there. Perfect.
Splashing?
Sure. Just need like two stitches.
Well, be quick about your two stitches then.
Hi, Bubby. Oh, look at that. It comes together.
Mm-hmm. One more stitch in here to pull this together. Is he jumping?
No, he's starting to.
Okay, let me just hold this.
Okay. Okay, Bub.
This is it. Good thing we have lidocaine, huh? See?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's tight. Let's put a glue right on this side just to sort of keep it from being too, too messy. And he's ready to jump up, so.
Where?
See, this is the thing right here, so just kind of right on top of there.
You okay. Made a right bloody mess.
Well, that's what happens when you hurry.
No,
when you're like,
not up off the table yet.
It's gonna be soon. This might need some. You know what? Let's do. Until he wakes up, let's put like
he's
a. Let's clean it up a little bit and let's put a pressure bandage on it.
Okie dokie.
Okay. Hi. Looking at us again.
A lot of people ask me about anesthesia and how safe it is. Well, there's no 100% safe anesthesia, but one thing we do at our clinics is we have a lot of monitors hooked up. As you can see, we had several things hooked up, and that wasn't even all the things. We also have a capnograph, which looks at the CO2 coming out and making sure that everything is normal there when we have them intubated as well. So we like to have a lot of monitors on. Now, Boss probably, if we hadn't had those monitors on and hadn't reversed him, he probably would have been fine. His blood pressure was good, everything was looking okay. It's unlikely he would have died from this. However, without the monitors on, we had no idea if there was a problem or wasn't. Because we had the monitors on, we could see that there was a problem and we could correct it right away.
Good job.
Hey, boss. Good hey, job. Boss.
You can relax now. Go and sit down.
Yeah.
You can sit.
Boss. Take a nap. Was that exciting?
It was very exciting.
Not in a good way.
No.
Hi, boss.